So today on Craig's Cabin, we are going down the woods and we're going to do a Food with Fred segment. So let's jump into it. Alright, so you want to cover loads of them. Put them on top. You've got a few loose ones. You've got about six covered.
Yeah.
It's fucking fun. Fucking fun. Get a big dot of it on there. Right. Put the rest in the tin.
Yep.
Right. Striker.
So we've got you dry on the bottom, and then you're going smaller and smaller, and then you've got leaves.
Yeah. Then striker and flint. Longest end because it's sharp end.
And you've got plenty of, plenty of holes in it for oxygen.
Flick the spark onto cotton wool balls.
Yeah.
Right.
So. Oh, it's this side, isn't it? Yeah.
Sharp, sharp end on it, and then flick it.
Like that?
Yeah. See again. The long end. Like it's a knife.
Oh, this way? Like that way? Oh, it's that way down.
There you go.
Oh, yeah, that one's getting up.
There you go. And you lit a fire with just some cotton wool balls, some like Vaseline. That.
Dry, isn't it?
Yeah, and you just want to feed it while it's getting going. Load of little dry sticks and dry leaves.
All the dry stuff. Yeah.
And then when it's all down to coals, be ready for us to cook on. Right, wait a bit to catch, and then put a little bit more on. A bit more. Just wait a bit to catch.
So the Vaseline burns quite a while, I suppose, isn't it?
Well, it's got petrol in it, so it'll burn for a bit. Cotton wool balls on their own burn really quickly, but you put some Vaseline on it, helps it burn a bit longer. Right, and that tool you've got behind you, there.
Yeah.
If it starts to go down, that little metal tube in that plastic tube.
This one.
That whistle. That one. Yeah. Is a bit extendable bellows. But don't
so what extendable
bellows? That's what they use to fan the flames.
Yeah, yeah. You just pull this off.
Yeah, you pull one end off and slide out. Keep feeding this. Don't want to start cooking on it till it's down to hot coals. Then we cook them burgers and then sausages and fresh baked rolls in the bakery this morning.
Yeah, not smuggler, do I?
I'm going to leave that burn for a bit. Wood's dry enough, it should catch up. So, we're going to do this food with friends down here in the woods. Instead of going to a restaurant, we're going to cook over this campfire. It's my friend Marvin, who is an occupational therapist. So, we've got our little fire going. Here is it, there. We've already cooked off some wild boar and red onion sausages. I've got them in a roll here with nice cheesy roll from the Rye Mill Bakery up in the Ore Village. And some garlic and herb mayo, so we're just trying these sausages out.
Yeah, his sausage is immense. Oh, now, red onion, wild boar, cooked to perfection, cheese roll, garlic and herb. Perfect, spot on.
There we go. And a thumbs up from Marvin and a thumbs up from me for these sausages. So, what we're going to do is I'm going to cook off another sausage just to show you how we cooked them off. And then when the fire's gone down a bit more and it's more coals than flames, then we're going to get some buffalo burgers on the go. Right, put the sausages on a bit of stick, and then all we've done is hold them over the fire, just keep turning and turning and turning for about 6 or 7 minutes. That's all we did. And then I took it off, I cut it through the middle, put the thing through it again, and hung it back over just to make sure the middle was still cooked, because I'm a bit fussy. So, boring red onion sausages, that's thumbs up from me.
It's all right.
So, Marvin, let's get on with these buffalo burgers.
I can't wait, mate. I can't wait.
So, if you grab the burgers.
Yep. Buffalo burgers, here they come.
All right, and now this is down to coals. It's perfect for it to cook on. All right. So, if you get down here, we'll put your saucepan there over that side. Like that. And mine there. Right, come down this side then, Marvin. It's alright, the smoke will go down in a minute.
Alright, yeah, there's the burgers there.
Alright, get one in your pan then. While they're cooking. Right, there we go, nice buffalo burgers in the frying pan.
Yeah, sizzling away, lovely.
Right. Right, turn these over. Ready? Oh, look at these burgers.
Oh, there they are.
They're cooking. So, the buffalo burgers are sizzling.
They are sizzling away, lovely.
I think they're about done. So I'm going to give these a test, see what they're like.
Check these out, yes.
Right. Well, we're going to go and enjoy these burgers. So, we've cooked off these buffalo burgers.
Oh yeah.
Put them in a cheese roll with a bit of cheese single and garlic and herb mayonnaise. Nice big juicy burger. Mm. Cooked all the way through.
Buffalo. Buffalo burger. Yeah, that's just a bit. Yeah.
Yeah. It's just like a meatier burger, isn't it?
It's really, really dense.
It's not as chewy as I thought it was going to be.
No, it's got a very rich iron taste, isn't it?
Because the buffalo steak I've had before.
Yeah.
And where you get a little bit of gristle on meat normally, it's very chewy. But that burger, it's lovely. In fact, our first time I cooked like that on that campfire.
Oh,
was
it?
Yeah. Because last time I used a pot on a, like my hobo pot I made.
Oh, right, yeah.
And I've cooked on a little dragon stove, which I've got in my bag as well.
Oh, yeah, seen that, yeah.
With the fuel tablets. And the homemade one I made out of a gas can as well. I've only cooked on them. I've not cooked like that on that fire before, so that was a first for me. And it didn't actually come out that bad.
No, it cooked really well. Cooked really fast. Cooked nicely all the way through. Browned off lovely.
So, what I'm going to have to do is rub these pots around with a cloth. So it keeps the flavour in the pan and keeps the coating on the pan, so I can use them more and more. So, the buffalo burgers, it's getting a thumbs up from me.
Thumbs up.
So, that was food with friends. Got my friend Marvin down here in the woods. Just a cheap little cook it up bit. And I went out and got some bushcraft meat. Well, bush meat, not bushcraft meat. Buffalo and wild boar. And surprisingly, it was a lot better than I thought it was going to be. So, don't forget, stay safe. Like, subscribe, and comment on the video. Share the channel, help us get up to 1,000 subscribers. Stay safe.